Mendocino was pretty liberal, but I worked in Fort Bragg, which was very, very rigid, very, very uptight. In fact, what happened as a result of that move and taking, I was working with adults with developmental disabilities in a nonprofit, and in one of our staff meetings, a coworker outed me in that meeting. It was a woman that was volunteering, and she said, "You know, I'm so sorry you're gay because I'm attracted to you." And we had an older woman on the staff who immediately reported back to the board of directors that I was a gay man working with these vulnerable young adults. And so within the next day, a sheriff appeared at the door under the pretext that someone was using my name as an alias, which is, anyway, he wanted to come in, we wouldn't let him in. It was obviously, the writing was on the wall that my job was in jeopardy. So I lost that job. Another thing that happened, to back up from that, when we were trying to go to Europe with our bicycles, I had to deal with the draft board because they weren't letting people leave the country, and so I came out when I was called for my physical. I just came out to the draft board and said, "Look, I have to tell you, I'm a gay man," because I didn't want to go to Vietnam, and I was called back 3 different times, and after the 3rd time, I got an order to register as a sex offender. And so,
was that normal then?
Oh yeah.
It typical of the times. Yeah. So I went. Fortunately, it was San Francisco. The draft board was Napa, but I was living in San Francisco. So I went down to the Hall of Justice, which was down near Chinatown at the time, and I said, you know, I've been ordered to register as a sex offender, and I don't know what to do. And he said, "Well, whom have you offended?" I said, I can't.
Oh, that person of opposite sex, right? Yeah.
And so I said, "Well, you know, I no one that I know of. I'm not even that active sexually, you know." And so he said, "Get out of here." He wouldn't do it. So thank God, my life would have been so different had he registered me. Well, that came from my passionate study of conscious aging. I thought, it's like coming out the first time. I can't age the same way my grandmother did or my aunts did, or, you know, they had so much invested in their family and the grandkids and everything, and I'm not going to have that. So how am I going to make meaning out of these later years? So I got really involved in going to all these workshops and conferences and seminars. I was just throwing myself into them. And at one of the conferences, I stood up and said, "Aren't there any other LGBT people here? Because I think we have some issues that are on top of this, you know?" And I said, "If there are, I'm going to be in the dining room tomorrow at noon, and seek me out, and let's talk." Well, I got 6 people out of the hundreds that were there, and some of them agreed with me that being LGBT was another layer of challenges. Others said, "Nah, I'm not interested." So. But anyway, I was heartened by that, and decided I wanted to bring conscious aging to my community. And address the other layer, which we have, of a shared history. And I mentioned masticating our memories is an important part of that process. We need, when I share with you about Drake's Dance Club, you've all had similar experiences. If I were in a group in the senior center with a bunch of straight people, I don't think they would relate, you know? And it's important that be validated, that experience be honored and validated.